Hi, Gloria. How are you?
How are you?
Oh, Mike, you did a superb job in China, and
sent me this, and I thought it was just great for cabinet meetings. It's to help you in making decisions. You can say that, and then you can say no, and you say maybe, and
first of all, on behalf of the group, we want to thank you for extending your hospitality. It's rather wonderful.
Thanks, Brad.
Diane Fuzzy Miller, are you
present?
Hi. How are you doing, sir?
Congratulations.
Hello.
Hello.
Jim Han.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
John Morris. Nice to meet you, sir.
Nice to see you. Eddie Lyons.
How do you do?
Now, we have got somebody else special for us. Yes, sir.
He's coming kind of like
you have
a
little something that my father has just been here coming within the last 4 days. There's a little letter that goes with it, so.
Yeah.
Well, I don't want to spoil this fun. I'm going to let him open.
Bring that home.
Okay. I'll go ahead. All right. We didn't know what to get a guy who has everything, so from little town in New Albany, we can give this one a deal. How's that?
And I'll tell you, the question is that it's made out of wood from Illinois and California.
And Washington.
Right. Golly. Well, thank you very much.
Well, thank you for inviting us. We appreciate it.
Yeah, but I didn't get to see the entire tournament, but I saw some things. And I think the most heartwarming fact I did see, I happened to be looking when somebody came out to congratulate you.
That was my secret.
And the funny thing was that the wife's name was Diane, which made me think that it was that I was watching somebody else. Oh Lord. I don't get to really sit down and watch
television.
I saw the finish of the tournament. Somebody won. Must have been one of the other tournaments that they were
going.
No, I was
home
with three little ones.
Well,
I've got to work on
it. Well, I thank you very much.
Sure.
Mr. President, we'd like to make you an honorary associate member of the United States Golf Association.
Well, thank you very much.
And I hope that occasionally you might be able to play with your golf.
Well, you do used to play quite a bit. Now it's about a New Year's holiday. Usually I'm at Walter Ansberg's place in Washington. I have my annual game of golf.
About 4 years plus from now, you'll have enough opportunity to play more golf.
Right.
And we also have some old additions of golf books that were first published in Scotland many, many years ago. If you have a spare moment, you might enjoy reading it.
Well, thank you very much. I'm very proud to have this. You know, I should have another book, another box of these for him. Now, sometime you read the paper and you decide that what I'm doing is all wrong.
No, I didn't say that. I just read the paper.
Someday when you do, well, here are some autographed golf balls, and you put one down and just slam it with it.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate that. Next year, I'll use this on the first one. Is that all right?
Yes, sir. Yes, when you start. Mr. President, thank you.
We appreciate it very much.
And I just, there.
Thank you. When you and I take it up together.
Oh, we'll go. Yes. Okay. Do they float? Do they float?
I haven't tried one.
No, you haven't tried one.
There are no water.
Every once in a while, we do have errant shots, you know what I mean? So we'd like to know if they would float. That would be great.
Well,
thank you very much.
Well, listen, I just. Again, congratulations. And I'm sorry that I was mixed up in my tournaments.
Oh, that's okay.
I was day open, in and out, and turning the set on when I could. And so I must have been looking at the wrong tournament.
Well, it's a very good possibility of that.
Do well this fall.
Yes. Lots of luck to you.
I'd like to come in as without in front as much as you.
Listen, would. don't go into a playoff, whatever. They're bad on my nerves, huh? I can imagine.
No, I have to give it to you for as controlled as you were on that.
Well, that's what the insides were jumping.
Yes, I can imagine.
They were jumping.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Hi. Oh, there.
Hi, Mr. President.
Hi, it's
a pleasure.
I've got something they want to give you, Mr. President.
Yeah, we'd like to send you a sweatsuit since you are an avid sports buff.
Well,
and thank you very much. You have the top, and then we have the bottom in there.
So you get the whole suit. Yeah.
Well, I thank you very much.
There you go.
Bobby, I don't have it in for a picture.
No.
Used to do it before.
Well, let's see. Actually, yeah, let's do
work. For a picture.
Okay.
The last time I saw a president's sweatsuit was on Air Force One when we were traveling overseas.
Yeah.
Just ugly old gray one.
We have a blue one here. You can chop some wood in that, maybe, or lift some weights, or
wear it around Camp David.
Yeah, that's right.
Yes. Okay. Well, I thank you very much. Very
thank you
to have that.
Yeah. Thank you,
Mr. President. What were you going to do? Their magazine here has such good circulation among runners and sportsmen and so forth. They're going to submit some written questions for us to work on with you for that. Fine. So we're going to get a good October interview in this magazine that be right up our alley.
Oh,
I'd be very pleased if I never made it if I'm running.
You stay in good shape.
I ran the quarter mile when I was in high school.
Oh, you did? I didn't
even know. Relay.
Is that right?
And then by the time I got in college, I had two sports that didn't mix. Swimming.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
And they didn't have any muscles, and I settled for swimming.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay, this is a souvenir.
Thank you.
I think I better have the pants though.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Okay. Actually, is there any possibility we could get like a shot if, like, maybe sitting down, like an interview?
Yeah, that would be good. In our chair.
Yeah, that'd be.
Yeah, really excited about working out this interview. I'll tell you, I know our readers are going to be really interested to read that. Actually, the issue that we're doing it has a couple of million readers, so the running has gotten pretty popular in this country.
Yes.
And certainly, I think with your interest in physical fitness, that certainly helps you. But I'll tell you, those sort of things really space it. It gets people off the buff and out on the roads or in the spas or whatever. I'm very pleased if it does.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much. Really appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Pleasure. Very good.
Thank you.
A lot, thanks a lot.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, really appreciate it. And we had a busy schedule, so.
Yeah.
All right. Okay.
Thank you.
Bye.
Sorry.
Good.
Very good to see you. Sandra, I'm David Berry.
Mr. President.
About time, Mr. President. And you last saw each other in Galena. I'm so impressed with the montage and what you've done.
Yes, correct.
Do well together, all those communities that want to pay tribute and honor to the Vietnam veterans, and when he said no president has ever done more to really bring recognition to the sacrifices made by our Vietnam veterans and President Reagan, I said you're speaking after my own heart.
That's very true.
I'm most grateful for what you're doing. I think it's wonderful and appreciate this very much.
Well, thank you, sir. This is the tribute that our organization has to offer individuals such as yourself, Mr. President, who has demonstrated in a public way a positive awareness of Vietnam veterans. And we recognize you for having done that twice in the last recent times. The first time, most poignantly, was the time when you appeared at the recitation of the names at the cathedral during the week when the dedication memorial was taking place. Nothing could have been more appropriate at the time than your prayers and your presence as a public citizen and a private citizen. We recognize that and we appreciate that. Our logo is Let the Healing Begin. I think that appearance of yours is the main ingredient to making that healing begin. And most recently, your appearance and your presence and your fine words at the Unknown Soldiers ceremonies, which I had the pleasure of attending as one of the ragtag veterans who marched along the streets of Constitution Avenue. But your words were gratifying. And once again, your leadership and your positive awareness is the type of thing that we want many more Americans to stand up and shout. And you've done an excellent job.
Well, I just think it's the cause was noble. And it was a tragedy in that somehow we couldn't get around to doing what you should do if you ask someone to fight and die for the country, and that is say, and win. You tied one hand behind your back.
Exactly.
Have any intention of winning. But, no, I hope that we're on that kind of recovery.
I think we are.
I have to tell you that the Memorial Day service was there. I wasn't sure it was going to
be. No.
Good to see you again, sir.
Thank you for making this possible.
Hi,
Don, this is the Vice President. You get two for
you?
One today.
Nice to see you.
Really quite
two for.
Please be offered, Mr. Vice President.
Nice to see you, sir. Nice to see you.
Don was very excited to come and see you.
Well, why don't we get down here and get a picture, which I know you want, and then I'll stand up and we'll all get a picture.
Great. Is that... And she wondered if you might sign, I think she's a little speechless at all this tension, but she wondered if you might sign her autograph book, and I thought that since the Vice President's here, we might ask you.
Those are
yours,
your daddy plays with them?
Golly.
Oh, nice.
Say, well, thank you very much.
Can I put them over here for you?
Yeah, and then I'll write.
Okay, I want to see if it looks like it's there.
No. Just where it was or any place, or shall I get back in close to where you there?
Have you been new?
Very good, sir.
Good to see you.
This is one of the more enjoyable parts of public life.
Oh, yeah.
Today we pulled up outside and she looked at it and she said, I can't wait to get my eyes on the president.
Can I get the vice president now, too?
Please.
Right.
All right.
Mr. President.
Oh, Well, now, you're giving each other the same thing. These are in a jar with the presidential seal on them, and it's got jelly beans in it. The jar has. Well, listen, you're a very brave young lady. And I know you're an inspiration to a lot of others who need the help.
We appreciate it. One quick story. We were waiting to come in the Roosevelt Room, looking at all the flags, the Marine Corps and the Army. And she turned, looked at the American flag, and said, "That's our flag." And I just thought, she's a real patriot.
Yes, it is.
So, thank you. We appreciate it.
Hello. Come in. Well, it's nice to see you.
Hi, I'm sure it's nice to see you.
See you, Matt. I see who climbed the Mount Everest.
Well, I know. I've been reading all about it and seeing in the pictures of the National Geographic.
Oh, great.
This is his stepfather.
Oh, I'm proud.
On behalf of the exhibition, I'd like to present you with the flag, the official flag that I carry.
Come on, Mom. Let's get over here.
And our official exhibition tie.
Well,
a very limited edition.
How are you, sir?
Very nice to see you. Well, I was thinking mountain climbing is something that you start out in the morning and finish before the day's over. You spent, what, 5.5 weeks or something?
Yeah, 61 days on the mountain.
61 days on the mountain.
Okay,
and then did it the hard way.
Yeah, got a lot of tough boys out there pulling for you. You might want to show them one video. This is an article that came out in the latest Geographic.
This is the thing that went out.
We had to get, it's a 4,000 foot buttress and then further up the mountain. Right there. We used a wind system and 6,000 feet of rope.
That's all there for fixing up a thing for hauling in the supplies.
We had a mile and a half of this ridge to walk along.
2 feet wide, isn't it?
Yeah.